So now we again same paper, that means EL 5503, same unit 2, and same chapter, same topic, cathode ray oscilloscope. We discuss now vertical amplifier, trigger circuit, time based generator. These are the different part of the CRO, not CR tube. So let's see what is inside the vertical amplifier, what is inside the trigger circuit, and what is inside the time based generator. Thank you. We already discussed how the pattern produced on the screen of the CRO. Now you can see that this is our block diagram of CRO. In this CRO, this is our vertical amplifier. Whatever the input signal that we want to see on the screen of the CRO, I repeat, whatever the input signal, that means we want to see sine wave, we want to see square wave, whatever the signal that we want to see on the screen of the CRO, this input is given to the vertical amplifier. This input that we want to see on the screen of the CRO, it is given to the vertical amplifier. Through vertical amplifier, it is given to the delay line, and through delay line, it is given to this vertical deflecting plates. This is, be remember that unknown signal, whatever the signal, unknown signal that which we can apply to the vertical deflecting plates through vertical amplifier and delay line. This is our trigger circuit and time-based generator. Right? Some of the portion of the input signal we are getting from the vertical amplifier to the triggering circuit, and then this triggering circuit generates the trigger signal, and it triggers the time based generator to generate the signal, and this signal it is given to the horizontal amplifier. For example, we want to see sine wave, then this sine wave it is applied to the input. This input is given to the vertical amplifier, amplification takes place and given to the delay line. See, now how to find out the time based generator is start, right? So some of the portion of the vertical amplifier is given to the trigger circuit. This trigger circuit gives trigger to the time based generator that अरे भाई यहां से सिग्नल आ गया, यहां इनपुट में कुछ सिग्नल है, तू ऑन हो, राइट, दैट द इन दैट वे. So some of the portion given to the trigger circuit which triggers the time based generator that or switch on कर time based generator से कहता है कि sweep wave or sawtooth wave generate and given to the horizontal amplifier which is given to the horizontal deflecting plates, and these plates gives us the input signal on the screen of the CRO. In this circuit works. The vertical amplifier consists of several stages with fixed overall sensitivity or gain expressed in volt per division. The advantage of fixed gain is that the amplifier can be more easily designed to meet the requirement of stability and bandwidth. The vertical amplifier is kept within its signal handling capability by proper selection of the input attenuator switch. The first element of the preamplifier is the input stage, often consists of the FET source like this. This is our FET amplifier. This is our main amplifier. Right? What is inside the FET amplifier? This FET amplifier source follows the whose high input impedance is isolates the amplifier from the attenuator. So this is your FET amplifier, this is your input attenuator, and this is your main amplifier. This structure is inside the vertical amplifier section. This FET input stage, this is our FET input stage, is followed by the BJT emitter follower to match the medium impedance of FET output with the low impedance input of the phase inverter. This phase inverter provides two anti-phase output signals which are required to operate the push-pull output amplifier. The push-pull output stage delivers equal signal voltage of opposite polarity to the vertical plates of the CRT. So through this, the output is given to the vertical two different deflecting plates of the vertical deflecting plates of the CR tube. The advantage of push-pull operation in CRO are similar to those obtained from the push-pull operation in other applications. Better hum voltage cancellation from the source or power supply, in addition, a number of defocusing and non-linear effects are reduced. Because neither plate is at ground potential. So this is the function of vertical amplifier. This is our basic CRO diagram, and we are now discussing about the trigger circuit and time-based generator. Right? What is inside the trigger circuit? What is inside the time-based generator? See here, हमें नहीं पता कि यहाँ हमने इनपुट सिग्नल दिया हुआ है. सो जो भी इनपुट सिग्नल यहाँ आएगा उसी वक्त इसको स्टार्ट होना पड़ेगा, तभी वर्टिकल डिफ्लेक्टिंग प्लेट्स पर और हॉरिजॉन्टल डिफ्लेक्टिंग प्लेट्स पर सेम टाइम सिग्नल मिलेंगे और ये दोनों यहाँ पर इसको दिखाई देगा, स्क्रीन पर हमको सिग्नल दिखाई देगा. सो व्हाट हैपेंड व्हेन द इनपुट सिग्नल इज गिवन हियर, सम ऑफ द पोर्शन वी आर टेकिंग टू द ट्रिगरिंग सर्किट. And this triggering circuit triggers the time-based generator. This time-based generator start and produce the sweep waveform to the horizontal amplifier. Amplification takes place and given to the horizontal deflecting plates. In this way, this circuit works. Here now, we are discussing about the sweep or time-based generator. This time-based generator, what is inside the time-based generator? What is inside the time-based generator? This is the circuit diagram of our time-based generator. This is the continuous sweep. Whenever we want to get continuous sweep, the sweep is like that. This is our sweep. We are getting this type of sweep at the output. We are getting sawtooth output like this. This is our waveform and this is our circuit diagram. This is our circuit diagram. Right? What is this? How it works? So, a continuous sweep CRO using a UJT as a time-based generator as shown in the figure. This is our UJT. This is our UJT. We are using UJT circuit diagram. The UJT is used to produce the sweep. When the power is first applied, the UJT is off and the CT changes exponentially through RT. Where is CT? This is your CT through RT, it is now in working condition. CT changes exponentially through RT, the UJT emitter voltage VE rise towards the VBB, and when VE reach the peak voltage VP as shown in the figure, see, this is our figure, right? When it reach, VE start generating the voltage, when it reach up to the VP, then the FET is discharging, capacitor is discharging, and we are getting lower voltage at the output, that means our sawtooth generator. I repeat, the UJT emitter voltage rise towards the VBB, and when it reach to the VE, it moves towards the VBB, because our supply is VBB, right? Our supply is VBB, so it moves towards the VBB. But when it reaches to the peak value, the emitter to base voltage B1 diode becomes forward biased and the UJT triggers on. This provides a low resistance discharge path and the capacitor discharge rapidly. The emitter voltage VE reach the minimum value rapidly and the UJT goes off. So when the UJT goes off, the output decreases towards the zero, but it is not zero, it is some of the value which is we are using VE, which name is VE. The capacitor recharge and the cycle repeats. Now again capacitor recharge and the second cycle, that means we are increasing the voltage towards the VBB, but it is not reached up to the VBB, but when it reach up to VP, the capacitor discharge, so we are getting the downward side. In this way it works. The improved sweep linearity, two separate voltage supplies are used, a low voltage supply for UJT and a high voltage supply for the RTCT circuit. RT is used for continuous control of frequency within a range, and CT is varied or changed in steps for range changing. They are sometimes called as timing resistor and timing capacitor respectively. That means this is our timing resistor or timing capacitor, we can also know. The synchronizing pulse enables the sweep frequency to be exactly equal to the input signal frequency, so that the signal is locked on the screen and does not drift. So this complete your this horizontal deflecting system in this sweep or time based generator. Now again we are discussing our original basic CR. So we know about the vertical amplifier, we know about the time based generator. Now how trigger pulse generated from the trigger circuit? That means we already discussed what is inside the vertical amplifier and how it works. We discuss about the what is the inside of the time based generator and how it works. Now we discuss about the trigger circuit, how, which type of the voltage, which type of the signal which is generated from the triggering circuit which triggers the time based generator. So for this our next figure is trigger sweep. This is our trigger sweep circuit diagram, through which we can generate the triggering waveform, whether it is sawtooth wave which is like this, right? We can see properly it is like this, right? This is our sawtooth wave generated from this circuit, generate this type of the waveform. How this circuit generate this type of waveform we discuss here. The trigger circuit is activated. The trigger circuit is activated by the signal of the variety of shapes and amplitudes which are converted to trigger pulse of uniform amplitude for the precision sweep operation. If the trigger level is set too low, the trigger generator will not operate. On the other hand, if the level is too high, the UJT may conduct for too long and part of the leading edge of the input signal may be lost. So with the help of this, this is our UJT trigger input circuit, trigger input which is given through VBB, it is produced the this type of the waveform. This is nothing but our trigger pulse produced pulse waveform. This is our output waveform. This is our x-axis, y-axis, VO, negative voltage, all it is given here. Right? Now the last circuit is the trigger pulse generator. See, now we want to generate the pulse waveform. This is our pulse type waveform. How we generate this pulse type of the waveform, then this is our trigger pulse circuit. This type of the pulse triggers the time based generator, and time based generator produce the sawtooth waveform to the horizontal deflecting plates, and we can see the structure of the waveform on the screen of the CRO. How it works, how this circuit works, The trigger circuit is activated by the signal of a variety of shapes and amplitudes, which are converted to trigger pulse of uniform amplitude for the precision sweep operation. If the trigger level is set too low, be careful. If the trigger level is set too low, the trigger generator will not operate. On the other hand, if the level is too high, the UJT may conduct for too long and part of the leading edge of the input signal may be lost. From the figure, the trigger input signal is applied to the voltage comparator. This is our voltage comparator. This is our input signal, which is given to the vertical amplifier through C1. We are applying to the comparator circuit. That means it compares the both the signal and given to the pulse generator, and the pulse waveform is produced. The trigger input signal is applied to the voltage comparator, whose reference level is set by the trigger level control on the CRO from the front panel. The comparator circuit, this circuit, C, produce a change in the output whenever the trigger input exceeds the present trigger levels. The pulse generator that follows the comparator produces negative trigger pulse. These produce negative trigger pulse, right? Like this. That produce a negative trigger pulse each time the comparator output cross its quiescent level, which in turn triggers the sweep generator to start the next sweep. The trigger sweep generator contains the stability or synchronizing control, which prevents the display from the jittering or running on the screen. Stability is secured by proper adjustment of the sweep speed. Sweep speed is adjustable by means of a sweep rate control and its multiplier. That is range control switch. The timing resistance RT. Where is RT? Timing resistance. RT is known as the timing resistance. Is used for the sweep rate control. And timing capacitor CT, we can see this RT and CT in the last figure. Is RT and CT is changed in the steps for sweep rate control. So we are getting our necessary sweep pulse circuit to trigger the time based generator. Be careful, time based generator signal and the vertical amplifier signal, both are reached at the same time, then we are getting the proper signal on the screen. So when both are at the proper time, both the signal, this is all trigger generator, trigger pulse, which generates the trigger circuit, that means sawtooth generator, which generates the sawtooth wave and given to the horizontal amplifier. At the same time, unknown signal which is given to the vertical deflecting plates, both the signal are reached at the same time. For when, if the vertical input signal, that means I repeat this again, horizontal signal or vertical signal, both are given to vertical and horizontal plate at the same time. For this purpose, there is a delay line. What is the function of delay line? To make sure the vertical signal and horizontal signal are reached at the same time. Then we are getting here proper signal. Right? So when the input signal that we want to see, it reach to the vertical deflecting plate, some of the portion given to the horizontal deflecting plates. Right? If there is some difference in time, then with the help of this delay line, we can delay this signal to reach the vertical signal. When this signal is reached, at the same time this signal is reached, this working condition is done by the delay line. So properly we are getting signal on the screen of the CRO. Thank you.